Now third property is associative property. What is the associative property? This is the grouping of numbers. This is the grouping of numbers. After changing the group, we get the same or different answer. It is depend on the different type of operation. That is, for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, it will be differ. Okay. Now let's study and let's discuss one by one. What is the associative property for addition? Here we will take minimum 3 rational number. Okay, here we will take minimum 3 rational number. That is A, B and C. So after grouping, we get the same or different answer. Let's say that is A plus B, B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Okay. That is for addition. For addition, grouping does not matter. That is, for rational numbers are associative for the addition. Okay. Rational numbers are associative for the addition. That is, it grouping does not matter in the addition. Okay. Let's take an example. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. After 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. Okay. So we will get the same answer. After adding, we will get the same answer. Okay. So we can say that rational numbers are associative for the addition. Okay. Now come for the subtraction. For subtraction, we will take the same three rational number A, B and C. So A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. That is, we can say that rational numbers are not associative for the subtraction. Okay, let's take an example. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, 1 by 4. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. We will not get the same answer. That is, it is not equal to. After solving, you will get that answer will not be same. So we can say that rational numbers are not associative for the subtraction. Okay. Now come for the multiplication. Multiplication. That is A into B into C. And after changing the grouping, A into B into C, this will be equal. That is, we can say that rational numbers are associative for the multiplication. Let's take an example. That is 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 into 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 into 1 by 4. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 12. Here 1 by 12 into 1 by 6 into 1 by 4. 1 upon 24 and here 1 upon 24. So we get the same answer. That is, we can say that rational numbers are associative for the multiplication. Okay. Now come for the division. For division. A divided by B and divide by C. And here A divide by B divide by C. This will not be equal. Okay. So we can say that rational numbers are not associative for the division. Let's take an example. 1 by 4. And here 1 by टू डिवाइड बाई वन बाई थ्री एंड डिवाइड बाई वन बाई फोर. तो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग यू विल गेट द आंसर विल नॉट बी सेम. ओके, तो वी कैन से दैट रेशनल नंबर्स आर नॉट एसोसिएटिव फॉर द डिवीजन. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी. नाउ कम फॉर द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी. फोर्थ वन इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी. डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज ए इंटू बी प्लस सी इक्वल टू ए इंटू बी एंड प्लस ए इंटू सी. एंड फॉर निगेटिव ए इंटू बी माइनस ए इंटू सी. इफ एनी नंबर प्रेजेंट इन दिस फॉर्म, इफ एनी नंबर प्रेजेंट इन दिस फॉर्म then we can elaborate this like this. First multiply the a into b. Here is the sign plus, so here will be the sign plus. A into b plus a into c. And for subtraction also a into b, here is the minus sign then minus sign a into c. Okay, let's take an example. For example 2 into 3 plus 4. So 2 into 3 and plus 2 into 4, that is the 6 plus 8, that is 14. Okay, now according to the part we will solve according to the Barbos rule. Okay, so 2 plus 3 plus 4 into, so 3 plus, according to the Barbos rule we will solve first bracket. So 4 plus 3 7 and 7 into 2 14, that is the same answer. Here is the same answer 14. So this is the distributive property. You can also solve this type of question like this. Okay, and you can also solve this type of question according to the Bodmer's rule. No matter, answer will be the same. Okay, what is the additive identity? If we add 0 in any number, then we get the same answer. So we can say that 0 is the additive identity. That is, after addition of 0 in any number, there will be no change in the number. So we can say that 0 is known as the additive identity. Okay? So 0 is called as additive identity. For example, 1 by 2 plus 0, we get the same answer, that is 1 by 2. 3 upon 4 plus 0, we get the same answer, 3 by 4. So we can say that 0 is known as the additive identity. Now come for the additive inverse. Additive inverse. Negative of any number is known as the additive inverse. ठीक है? Negative of any number is known as the additive inverse. That is minus 10. The additive inverse of minus 10. Negative of minus 10. That is the plus 10. Okay? तो minus 10 is the additive inverse of plus 10 and plus 10 is additive inverse of minus 10. That is minus 3 is the additive inverse of plus 3 and plus 3 is the additive inverse of minus 3. So negative of any number is known as the additive inverse. Okay, now come for the multiplicative identity.
if we multiply 1 in any number, then we get the same number. So we can say that 1 is the multiplicative identity. Okay,
for example, 10 into 1 equal to 10, we get the same number. 12 into 1, we get the same number. 1 by 3 into 1, we get the same number.
That is, 1 is known as the multiplicative identity. Okay, now come for the multiplicative inverse. This is also known as the reciprocal. If multiplication of two numbers is resultant 1, then we can say that both the numbers are reciprocal or multiplicative inverse of each other. For example, 1 by 3 are into 3 by 1. After multiply, we get the 1. So, 1 by 3 is the multiplicative inverse of 3. And 3 is the multiplicative inverse of 1 by 3. Okay, that is, for example, 5 by 4 into, if we multiply the 5 by 4 by 4 by 5, we get the 1. That is the 4 by 5 is the multiplicative inverse of 5 by 4, and 5 by 4 is the multiplicative inverse of 4 by 5. That is the 3 by 4 is the multiplicative inverse of 4 by 3, and 4 by 3 is the multiplicative inverse of 3 by 4. So, after multiplication of multiplicative inverse, we get the 1 answer. So, we can say that both the numbers are multiplicative inverse of each other. Okay?